This clip will look at the My Activities tab on the Tutor Portal. From the home screen, if you hover over the My Activities tab, you will see there are four submenus. Activities this year, in which you can have all, proposed, approved, in progress or completed. Course documents, course information sheets for this academic year, course information sheets for the next academic year, and tutor report forms. You can also look at activities in other years, in this example, 2016 being the next academic year, and 2014 being the last academic year. You can also see the last four activities that you have looked at. So for example, here we have Live and Let Die Again, The Bird Song, Advanced Hula Hooping, and Beginner's IT. So let's look at activities this year and choose all. Here you will see the full list of all the activities in this current academic year for your Tutor Portal account. If you look down at the bottom, you can see that there is only one page, and to the right hand side, there are seven records, and this list is showing records 1 to 7. All these activities are in a state of being either cancelled, proposed, or approved, or in progress. You can see this by the status on the list. So let's look at cross-stitching for beginners. You click on View to see the activity. And here you will see all the basic details of the course. So the start and end dates, session start time and the day, how many sessions and how many hours of each session, total hours, etc. Coming down to the bottom, you can now perform the following actions. If you hover over the following actions, you get a sticky menu with 5 separate choices. You can choose the course information sheet for this activity, which indicates here that it is already in progress. Your tutor report form, which is required. There is one contract against this activity, no claims have been made, or you can raise a query or request a change. Let's choose this option first. For example, if the date is wrong, you can indicate this to your organiser or learning manager via the portal. So in this box, you would need to type, please change the start date to 25th of December 2016. Once you click on send, that will send an email message directly to your organiser or learning manager with the details of the course and the information that you requested. We're not going to send this information, but we'll just close this box. Your organiser should then respond to you fairly quickly. If we go back to the following actions, we can go directly to the course information sheet. There is a separate video showing you how to complete course information sheets. But again, on this section, you can see the basic details of the course with the themes and the course outline information. Let's go back on the browser. And you're back to My Activities. Okay, let's go back to cross-stitch for beginners, following actions, and let's look at the tutor report form. Again, you have the same course information and the themes, and then you have the boxes that are required to be completed on the tutor report. Again, you will need to save all your work, and once you've completed all the sections, the submit button will become available to you. Likewise with the course information sheet, once you submit the tutor report form, you cannot make any changes to it. Okay, let's go back to the activities and back to cross-stitch. More actions. Let's look at the contracts. Clicking on the contracts, you will see that there is one contract against this activity. It's a tutor type of contract. It has the contact reference and also the activity details, as in the name and the reference. The start and end date and the status of the contract is provisional. It is envisaged that very soon you will be able to accept contracts via the portal. Currently, at the time of making this video, you are able to accept contracts via email from your administrators. Let's look at this contract by clicking on View. And again, it gives you the basic course information. Down at the bottom, you will see contract confirmation received. This will have a date in once the contract has been received by the admin team. Okay, let's go back to my activities now. Hovering over again, you can see that you can choose any of these options just to narrow down the courses that you want to see in particular. This is quite useful when you have a lot of courses in your portal.